study, how some people could resist the COVID-19 virus. On one hand, some COVID-19 cases are either severe or critical. On another, cases were reported with resistance to the coronavirus. This confused experts as to why these individuals exhibited resistance. Recently, a research group offered an explanation: abortive infections. But before we continue, please like this video if you find this informative and subscribe to our channel for more interesting and informative content. Don't forget to click the bell icon too to get the latest updates. In the journal Nature, University College London researchers published their findings to explain how some patients resisted a COVID-19 virus. The study began after data from dozens of UK healthcare workers suggested something interesting. Their bodies could quickly get rid of the coronavirus without testing positive for the virus or producing detectable antibody levels. That surprised them because infections would normally send antibody levels through the roof. I've never seen anything like that. It's really surprising that the T cells might be able to control an infection so quickly, said Shane Crotty, an immunologist at La Jolla Institute for Immunology who wasn't part of the study. In the study, researchers examined the blood samples of almost 60 UK healthcare workers. The samples were collected in the first weeks of the pandemic. All of them worked in hospitals that made them at risk of contracting the disease. Despite their exposure risk, no one tested positive or produced antibodies against the coronavirus for 4 months after enrolling in the study. Of those, 20 were seronegative or didn't produce antibodies at all. However, their T cells were found high, indicating an infection. Of those 20, 19 healthcare workers were also identified with an increased level of IF127 immune-related protein. Researchers believe this protein might be a marker of SARS-CoV-2 infection. Among those individuals, the coronavirus entered the body and attempted to invade healthy cells. Yet the immune system responded so fast that the virus failed. Researchers highlighted abortive infections or the pathogen's failure to properly establish itself inside a body. They suspected that T cells disabled the replication transcription complex of the virus, which hampered its replication process. Although the findings are interesting, researchers warned that their study had many caveats. So, it's too early to say what actually stopped the virus from taking over. What do you think about the study findings? Can T cells really stop the coronavirus without help from antibodies? Share your thoughts in the comment section. Till our next video, thanks for watching.